When I got home, I got a phone call, and it said the plane had gone down.
My phone rang, and my dad was on the other end, and he kind of gave me the news. And at first, I wasn't sure what he was saying.
I had a really bad feeling, just because it was 8:45. He hadn't called. He was supposed to be home at 8.
Ann answered the phone, and all of a sudden, the conversation turned. We just hit the ground, just face first, and started praying that they'd made a mistake.
And I'll never forget it. He just goes, "Karen, I don't know how to tell you this, but what was on that plane?"
They were sleeping. They went to bed knowing that they had a dad. They woke up in the morning, and dad was gone.
A plane carrying 8 passengers and 2 pilots did crash tonight.
Pat and Nate and Brian, seeing those guys, their faces in the windows as they were pulling out of that hangar. That's the one thing I remember before they took off.
For the first couple of hours, every person whose cell phone I knew on that plane, I tried to call over and over and over, just thinking that, you know, someone might answer, and if I just keep calling, maybe something, you know, someone might answer. But then, you know, reality started to set in.
Even to this day, you don't believe. You know, you have to keep kicking yourself and saying, "Hey, my son's no longer here."
When you're a father and you're there from day one, literally, with that person, you love them more than anything you can ever comprehend, anything you ever dreamed about before that.
Put yourself in that position and try to think, how would you deal with it, how hard that would be? And, you know, I can't imagine.
I broke down, and I started crying, and people was like, "Man, you're all right, you're all right." And it was just something that I couldn't let, you know, let go. It was just something that was strong. It's sort of like a strong wall that you can't break through.
At the basketball home of the Cowboys, Gallagher-Iba Arena, the Oklahoma State community gathered in a memorial service for the fallen 10.
Kendall Durfee, William Hancock III, Pat Noyes, Bjorn Falstrom, Daniel Lawson Jr., William B. Teagans, Nathan Fleming, Brian Lewinstra, Jared Weiberg, Denver Mills.
Boy, it was tough going to those funerals, and it was just tough seeing parents and seeing wives, and you know, you didn't know exactly what to say.
There's times that I would have traded spots for a couple of some of those guys on that plane.
Kyle Keller, at the time an assistant coach, had flown to Colorado on the prop plane that would eventually crash. But for that return trip to Stillwater, he fatefully switched aircraft with a 20-year-old freshman, Nate Fleming, his cousin.
Why our plane didn't go down, or why I wasn't on that plane, or whatever, I don't ask why. It's not a question I even ponder.
10 days before, I had a dream that Will was killed in an accident, and woke up like you do from a dream like that, just in a panic. Was it real? Was it a dream? And was overjoyed to realize that it was only a dream. Called Will at his office, and we talked for an hour, and that's the last time we talked.
The father's final message to his son, one he had expressed countless times.
3 words: I love you.
Life. He loved his family. We never had an argument. He was a good kid.
He was my little brother. And A lot of times I probably didn't do the best job of showing it, but he knew it, and I know that he knew it, and you know, loved him a lot.
When we had to go up and move his furniture out, we found all the letters that I'd written over the years, you know, from junior high on, he'd saved every one of them. So it's tender for a dad.
Everything he was, he still is. He's just not here. And he was a great man. He was so kind and so smart, so thoughtful, so generous, just a great guy. Wonderful husband. He would have been a great dad. He was a great dad for 2 months. She's the biggest reason that there is to go on. I mean, there is the joy of getting to see little bits of Will in her as she grows.
When I watch on TV, I'm looking for him at the end of the bench.
And he's there, but we can't see him.
See him.
There is a feeling that Will is always right there with me. I talk to him sometimes, and it's quite comforting.
In the St. Joe game, when John Lucas hit that last second shot and then ran into the stands and jumped up and hugged his dad, it just just brought me to my knees, because I've been there and done that with Nate, and I've felt the sweat and felt his cheek against mine, and so I was envious, and at the same time, I was real happy for the two of them that they're getting to experience that.
The Final Four is not a conclusion to what happened to us back in January. I just think this is a great way we can honor those 10 men and those families, and hopefully that will, for this time, we can ease a little bit of pain for what that whole family and what this program has gone through.